Hello guys, welcome back to the channel. So first of all, just simply log in with your credentials, and once you're done with that, just simply come back over here, click on the checkbox, and then click on agree and continue. Now what you do, just simply click on the setup and requirement, just simply scroll down, and from here what you do, you have to just simply open this link. So just simply open this link in incognito window like this way, wait for a couple of seconds. Click on this go to product page like this way, and now just simply wait over here. Now just simply click on this get started, and then just simply click on the checkbox, and then click on this agree. Now just simply click on this go to product page like this way, and just simply wait for a couple of seconds, and then click on this launch. Now I request you please watch the video carefully because this is a very important task. Now what you do, just simply come back to the lab instructions, and from here just simply copy this DNS name, just simply copy like this, come back over here, and here you can see Active Directory, just simply paste the name over here like this way. Now here you can see primary zone and secondary zone. So for me, the given primary zone is Europe West 1B. So I'm going to choose that. So you can do one thing, just simply copy like this way. Come back over here, and this is my primary zone. So just simply click over here and just simply search for it like this way. And here you will get a primary zone like this way. Now just simply click over here and it's done. Now for the secondary zone, just simply come back over here, and from here just simply copy the secondary zone over here. Just simply copy like this. Come back over here. Again, just simply click on your secondary zone like this way. Again, just simply search for it, and then just simply choose your secondary zone, and make sure that both the zone must be different as per the lab instruction page. Okay, once you're done with both the things, just simply scroll down. Now here you can see primary machine type and for the secondary machine type. What you do, just simply come back over here, and from here just simply choose the E2, and for the machine type it must be E2 standard 2 because it's mentioned on the lab instruction page. Now for the secondary machine type, again just simply click over here, and from here just simply choose the E2, and then for the machine type it must be E2 standard 2. You are done with all the configuration. Just simply scroll down, and then just simply click on this deploy over here. Now this thing is going to take at least 10 to 20 minutes, so just simply wait for that. and it's finally done. Now what you do, just simply click on this dashboard over here like this way, and then just simply activate your Cloud Shell. It will take a couple of seconds, so just simply wait for that. And now click on continue. Now in the description box of this video, I will share all these commands. So basically what you do, just simply come back to the library instructions and just simply click on the task number 1. And just simply scroll down, and from here you can see this zone. So just simply copy this zone like this way, and this is your first zone. Just simply remember that. So just simply come back over here and just simply paste over here at the place of zone 1. Okay, now for the zone 2, what you do, just simply come back to the lab instructions and just simply click on the task number 4. Just simply scroll down, and from here you can see this zone. So this is your second zone. So just simply copy like this way, copy like this, come back to the notepad and just simply paste over here, and make sure that there is no extra space after equal to. Okay, now copy all these command like this way, and make sure that you have to copy this full stop as well. Copy like this, come back over here, just simply paste, hit enter, wait for a second, and then just simply click on this authorize button. Now we have to just simply wait for this command get execute, and once it's done, we are done with this lab. So just simply wait for a couple of minutes and let's see. And it's done. Do not worry about this error. If you just simply come back to the lab instructions and click on the check my progress for each and every task, you will get a score without any issue. And if the score is not updated, no need to worry. Just simply wait for a couple of seconds. You will get a full score on this lab without any issue. And that's the way we have to complete this lab. If you still have any doubts, please do let me in the comment section. Thanks for watching and have a good day, guys.